Very good morning, cadets. Hope you are all doing well. We are in chapter number 1 from history, Rise of Nationalism in Europe. We completed the topics of Italian unification, German unification, liberalism, political liberalism, economic liberalism, and other major topics related to the chapter. Today, let us study about visualizing nation. What do you mean visualization of nation is? Today, when I say India, the image, what image is coming to your picture or image coming to your brain, that is Kashmir to Kanyakumari, Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, this is a united India. So we have national anthem, we have a national flag, we have a national animal, and we have a concept of Bharat Mata. That is what, how we visualize or personify our country. Now imagine the situation in 18th century in India, or prior to 18th century, maybe 16th, 17th century. 17th century, that was a time where British gained their power in India, who landed in India as the traders. But prior to that, India was ruled by Mughals, Marathas, Wadars of Mysore, Sultans in Adil Shahi, Vijayanagara Empire. So definitely the what concept of united India which today we have, definitely it was not there few centuries back. So what is visualizing nation is nothing but personifying a nation, okay, personifying a nation, and how nation is represented to a person, okay. Nations were then portrayed as a female figures, and the female form were chosen to personify the nation, and nation did not stand for a women in a particular life. Means it is not a iconic figure from the realistic society, rather it's just a personification of women, and it is an abstract idea and in a concrete form. What is this called? This is called as allegory. So allegory of a nation. So the female allegory of the nation, that is what we have in India also. We call India Bharat Mata. So what is Bharat Mata? Is nothing but female allegory of a nation. When we recall during the French Revolution, the artists used female allegory to portray the ideas such as liberty, justice and republic. These ideals were presented through specific objects of symbols, as they would remember the attributes of liberty are the red cape, broken chain, while justice is generally blindfolded, women carrying a pairs of weighing scales. You may be seen very common in movies and all, when the court proceedings are going, then the goddess of justice is blindfolded and carrying a pair of weighing scales, a balance scale. Why? Because blindfolded, because while delivering justice, the person who is in the judgmental seat should not biased, he should be unbiased. He should not give judgment based on his biased opinion. Rather, he should give judgment purely based on the facts and evidences. That is what he has to do. Okay. Similar female allegories were invented by the artists in 19th century to represent the nation. in France she was christened. So now the Christian religion influenced on the name of the French allegory, which underlined the idea of people's nation. Her characteristics were drawn from those of liberty and republic. Red crab, tricolor, red crab, black cockade, and it was installed in a public place with a symbol of national unity to persuade the identity of nation. Similarly, Germania became the allegory of German nation, and Germania wears a crown of oak leaves, as the German oak stand for heroism. If you remember, during the Olympics medaling ceremony, they make the crown of oak leaves. Oak stands for sign of heroism. Please remember, Germania became an allegory of German nation, and Germania wears a crown of oak leaves. What is the symbol of oak leaves? Is nothing but symbol of heroism. Okay, this is what the symbol of, or the allegory of Germania. You can see here oak leaves. This oak leaves stand for symbol of heroism, but this leaves, oak leaves, meant for ready to sign for a treaty. This sword is symbol of readiness for the war. You can see the bright sunshine, sun rays. It is nothing but hope. This is a symbol of Germany. So lot of ideas in a single picture or single painting of allegory. So whenever allegory is portrayed in such a way that allegory is portrayed with the culture of that particular country, that is what the speciality of any allegory. Okay, so what is the meaning of allegory? Allegory, when an abstract idea, for instance greed, envy, freedom, liberty, is expressed through a person or a thing, an allegory story has two meanings. One is literal, another one is symbolic. Symbolic meaning, that is what I said, oak leaves, the symbol of ready to peace, or the symbol of bravery. These are all symbolic meanings of any allegory. This is the allegory of France. Now you see, certain meanings are given here. What is broken chain represents? Broken chain represents being free, means broken the shackles of the chain so that he is enjoying his freedom. Breastplates and eagle, what is it that symbols? The German Empire strength. Crown of oak leaves, what it represents? Heroism. Sword, readiness to fight. Olive branch around the sword, what is the indication of that? That is willing to make peace. Now you see, the crown of oak means heroism. Olive branches meant for willing to make peace. Sorry, there is a correction, because I told initially it was a oak leaves. Black, red and gold tricolor, the flag of liberal nationalist in 1484 banned by Duke of German States. The ray of rising sun, that is the beginning of new era. This is a fallen Germania, picture of 1850. This is Germania guarding the rain, Alps and Rhine mountains. Okay, so this is related to allegory and visualization of nation state. Now let us move to the next major topic, that is nationalism and imperialism. By the last quarter of 19th century, Nationalism no longer retained its idealistic liberal democratic sentiments of the first half of the century. Means, by the second half of 19th century, every country changed their attitude towards the neighboring countries. Each country tried to encroach or expand their geographical area. That's the reason why they were ready to go for war. The major European powers in turn manipulated the nationalist aspirations of the subjects people in Europe for further their own imperialist aims. So what is imperialism? In a brief meaning, imperialism is nothing but economically powerful countries controlling the activities of weak nation. It's called imperialism. Controlling or influencing. Influencing, that is also a part of imperialistic attitude. What today America is showing on weak nations is imperialistic attitude, threatening other countries because they were economically or militarily they are weak. The most serious source of nationalist tension in Europe after 1817 was the area called Balkan states. The Balkan state, please remember Balkan states. Okay, Balkan states, Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, Greece, Macedonia, Croatia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Slovenia, Serbia, Montenegro. So, if you remember one famous song in Kannada, Romania, Bulgaria, Hungary, all these Balkan states. Now, most of the Balkan states were controlled by Ottoman Empire. If you remember Ottoman Empire, we discussed about Ottoman Empire in the independence of which country? Greece. Yes. So, Romania, Bulgaria, Albania, Greece, Macedonia, Croatia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Slovenia, Serbia and Montenegro, they were all inhabited, they are known as Pan-Slavic countries, they are called Slavic population or Slav population. So the area was called as what? Balkan province. So after 1871, the tension increased in the Balkan provinces. A large part of Balkan was under the control of Ottoman Empire of Turkey. The spread of ideas of romantic nationalism in Balkans together with the disintegration of Ottoman Empire made region very very explosive. We studied about Treaty of Constantinople. Greece freed itself from the clutches of Ottoman Empire. So when the nationalism spirit increases in the Balkan provinces, it led to the rise of national states, and each and every Balkan state tried to declare war against Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire made this region very explosive, although the 19th century Ottoman Empire Ottoman Empire had sought to strengthen itself through the modernization of internal reforms with very little success. One by one, its European subjects, nationalists, broke away from its control and declared independence. The Balkan people, based on their claims for independence or political rights or nationality, and used history to prove that they had once been independent but had subsequently been subjugated by foreign powers. Hence, rebellious nationalists in the Balkans thought of their struggle as attempt to win back their long lost independence. As the different Slavic nationalists struggled to define their identities or independence, the Balkan area became an area of intense conflict. Please write down all these things. Balkan states were fiercely jealous of each other and hoped to gain more territory by the expansion of each other. Because they were all closely connected states, all the Balkan states. So each state tried to capture the neighbor's territory, so they wanted to expand. Matters were further complicated because of Balkan also became a scene of big power rivalry. During this period, there was intense rivalry among European powers over the trade, colonies, as well as naval and military might. The rivalries were evident on the way of Balkan problems unfold. Each European powers, Russia, Germany, England, Austro-Hungary, was keen in countering hold their power over Balkan states. Now try to understand why there was intense struggle in Balkan state, because the powerful countries of Russia, Germany, England, Austro-Hungary, they were all trying to control Balkan area, so that they wanted to control Balkan and they wanted to influence their power mainly for the trade purpose. This led to the series of war and finally led to the First World War. So Balkan provinces, why Balkan provinces are very important, please go through once again. Write down the names of Balkan. Why we study about Balkan wars? Most of the time it is asked for 3-mark question. Balkan states are those states which were once under the control of Ottoman Empire, and each and every Balkan states wanted to declare their independence, and the intense rivalry in the Balkan provinces led to the several wars, and finally it clashed or landed in the First World War. This is what the painting of world at that time, because of the trade route. Okay, so what is at the top angle? Angels are showing carrying banner of freedom, Britannia symbol of nation, and sitting over the globe, colonies were represented through images of tigers, elephant, forest. Now you see England, the crown. Okay, they were capturing all the colonies. Now you see, the colonies are shown as colony, like India. India was a colony at that time. Now you can see the angels here: freedom, loyalty, federation. They are all the Christian world angels. They were all blessing whom? That is England. So England capturing the world, and they are all showing that the colonies of British were very primitive. Means they were all not civilized according to the this painting. Okay, so this is the, so now you see the colonies are represented through the images of tiger, elephant, forest, and primitive people. The domination of world shows that is the basis of British nation's pride. So with this I completed the chapter number 1 of history. Okay, quickly we'll go through all the slides which completed till now. It's a big chapter, more than 130 slides are there. Okay, but important topics you have to. Okay, so we gone through various topics. The Frederick Soraya's painting, then I explained about the importance of this painting. Okay, French Revolution, which we studied in very detailed manner in the last year, how French flag tricolor was chosen to replace the royal standards. Napoleon Bonaparte civic code, one or two cadets asked the civic code of Napoleon Bonaparte. So Napoleon Bonaparte, the civic code, what are the things, because all the bus bridge privileges were cancelled, equality before law, right to property, then administrative divisions, abolished feudal system. He freed peasants from the serfdom and manorial labor. In the towns, guild two restrictions were removed, transport and communication improved, peasants and artisans and enjoyed newfound freedom. So these are the major points of Napoleonic Code of 1804. Okay, and further, that is standardized, that is uniform weights and measures, common national currency, free movement of means, facilitate the movement of goods and services by reducing the number of currencies into single currency, introducing uniform weights and measurements. There are a lot of steps introduced by Napoleon Bonaparte in Napoleonic Code. The making of nationalism, this is what the beginning of nationalism, how various nations try to identify them as different by projecting their culture, language, literature, flag, etc. Okay, Congress of Vienna, definitely you have to remember, because Congress of Vienna is after the Battle of Waterloo, that is in the 1815, and the countries which defeated, collectively defeated Napoleon Bonaparte, they signed the Treaty of Vienna. And not only Treaty of Vienna, very important, by signing Treaty of Vienna, they tried to stop the expansion of France. Important dates: invasion of on Italy, fall of Napoleon Bonaparte, that is in the Battle of Waterloo, then Greek struggle for independence, then revolutions of 1848, artisans, industrial worker, peasants, and all those. We are studied in detail about all these things. Then unification of Germany and unification of Italy. Please remember all the topics, very important. Unification of Germany, unification of Italy. Then finally, we ended with the chapter of Balkan Wars, that is Pan-Slavic countries, how the Balkan Wars led to First World War. Then we studied about aristocracy and middle class. Aristocracy means people belongs to first and second estate or the rich people. So aristocracy. Then we studied about middle class population. Middle class population is purely because of Industrial Revolution. Industrial Revolution, labor class and middle class population, why played a major role? Because most of the middle class population, they were all highly educated, and because of they were highly educated, they started rebelling against the old system. Okay. Then we studied about liberal nationalism, and liberal nationalism is a 5-mark question. Please write down the important topics of liberal nationalism. Liber means free. We studied about political liberalism, economic liberalism. Okay. Political liberalism, they supported for the government, representative government, constitution, elections and all. But what is the problem of political liberalism? That they are not supported universal adult franchise, rather they supported limited franchise. They supported limited franchise. We also studied about universal suffrage. Sorry, not universal suffrage. It is about limited suffrage, because the voting right is not given to men. Economic sphere. Zollrin, please remember Zollrin, because that is a customs union. Then we studied about conservatism. Conservatism is nothing but reinforcement of all the traditional institutions, because churches, social hierarchy, monarchy, was everything was re-established after the fall of Napoleon Bonaparte. Remember the four countries: Britain, Russia, Prussia, and Austria collectively defeated Napoleon Bonaparte in the Battle of Waterloo. Congress of Vienna was led by Duke Metternich. Okay. The freedom was banned because of conservatism. Censorship was imposed. Then we studied about various revolutions of 1815. Then Carbonary Society, secret societies. Mesny led the secret society of 1807, and that is Carbonary, and Young Italy and Young Europe. Okay. Then we also completed the Age of Revolutions of 1830 to 1848. Constantinople, Treaty of Constantinople of 1832 recognized Greece as an independent nation. Studied about Romanticism, Peasants' Revolutions. Revolutions by liberals and German unification, then Italian unification. Okay, making of Germany and Italy. This is Italian unification and German unification. Kaiser William I proclaimed as German Emperor. Okay. So please go through all these slides: Italy before and after unification, Germany before and after unification, leaders who were involved in unification of Germany. This is Italy after unification, this is Italy prior to unification. Okay. So in the next video session we'll discuss about question and answers related to the chapter. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you very much. Okay, Ottoman Empire we completed. Okay, so next we'll discuss about question and answers related to the chapter. Okay, wish you a wonderful day once again. Thank you.